Hi, my name is Mark. Greetings to all my fellow truth seekers and brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. There are some that teach a limited atonement, which means that Jesus did not die for the sins of the whole world. But what does the whole Word of God teach us about the atonement of Jesus? Please read 1 John chapter 2, verse 2. And he, speaking of Jesus, is the propitiation, that is to say, the atonement for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. Now these are plain and simple words in this verse, which make it perfectly clear that Jesus died, that is to say, was the atonement for the sins of the whole world, and not for just a select few who were chosen or predestined to be saved from the foundation of the world, as some falsely teach. Now the Word of God warns us that there shall arise false teachers among us in the last days, who will bring in damnable and destructive heresies, or false teachings, into the body of Christ. Please read 2 Peter chapter 2, verses 1 and 2. But there were false prophets among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privately shall bring in damnable or destructive heresies, even denying the Lord that bought them, and bring upon themselves swift destruction, and many shall follow their pernicious ways, by reason of whom the way of truth shall be evil spoken of. Now I want you to read the same verse of Scripture from a couple of other different translations. Here is 2 Peter chapter 2, verses 1 and 2 from the Basic Bible English translation. But there were false prophets among the people, and there will be false teachers among you, who will secretly put forward wrong teachings for your destruction, even turning away from the Lord who gave himself for them, whose destruction will come quickly, and they themselves will be the cause of it. And a great number will go with them in their evil ways, through whom the true way will have a bad name. I want you to take a moment and think about those in the world who are hearing this message of limited atonement. Now for me, if I was not already saved, I would have to wonder if I was one of the elect or chosen ones from the foundation of the world to be saved. In other words, there would always be this doubt if I was one of the lucky ones who were elected to be saved. To me, this doctrine of limited atonement is a damnable heresy that pushes away unbelievers from the true message of the atonement, which is that Jesus died not only for the elect, which in truth, the elect means those who have chosen to believe God's word, but also that Jesus died for the sins of the whole world, which means all of mankind, which also includes everyone who has not yet come to the knowledge of the truth. So what is the knowledge of the truth? Please read John chapter 3, verses 16 and 17. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that, or for this reason, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Now let's read 2 Peter chapter 2, verses 1 and 2 again from the New Century Version. There used to be false prophets among God's people, just as you will have some false teachers in your group. They will secretly teach things that are wrong, teachings that will cause people to be lost. They will even refuse to accept the Master Jesus who bought their freedom, so they will bring quick ruin on themselves. Many will follow their evil ways and say evil things about the way of truth. Now again, the way of truth is that Jesus died for the sins of the whole world. Please read John chapter 1, verse 29. The next day John, referring to John the Baptist, seeing Jesus coming unto him and said, Behold the Lamb of God, which takes away or bears the sin of the world. Now those that teach the limited atonement say that the word world has many meanings and does not always mean the whole world. However, the Bible teaches us that Jesus was the Lamb of God and that he was slain from before the foundation of the world for all of mankind. So there is no valid reason to change the simple and clear meaning of Jesus being the atonement for the whole world, which we are plainly taught in 1 John chapter 2, verse 2. To Jesus taking away the sins of the world to mean that Jesus only bore the sins of a few who were elected or chosen from the foundation of the world. In other words, if the atonement is found to mean the whole world in one place in the Word of God, then in every place we find throughout the Word of God that Jesus died for the sins of the world, then the word world is to, without a doubt, mean the whole world. Please read 1 John chapter 2, verse 2 from the New International Version. He, speaking of Jesus, is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not only for ours, but also for the sins of the whole world, that is to say, all of mankind. I believe God knew that there would be false teachers who would teach a limited atonement, which falsely teaches that Jesus did not die for the sins of the whole world, and therefore made sure that it was plainly and clearly stated in his word. And Christ himself is the means by which our sins are forgiven, and not ours only, but also the sins of everyone in the whole world. This is from the Good News translation, which is truly good news indeed. Thanks for watching. May God bless you richly as you continue to seek the truth of the whole Word of God. If this video has blessed you, please favor it. And please don't forget to subscribe so that you can stay informed of any future videos. Please feel free to download or copy any of my videos to use on your channel or to share with others. To find any of my videos, please click on my channel name, A Matter of Truth, or where it says videos above. And for more in-depth studies on this or other subjects, please visit my website at amatteroftruth.com. Please view the next video in this series entitled Number 2, Is the Doctrine of Limited Atonement the Truth of the Word of God?